stars. Our next fight is going to be in the middleweight division. We're going to see a young up-and-comer from Washington, D.C., Marquis Moore, just 21 years old. He's been fighting for 11 years, and he's going to take on another Fowler, but this one is from Liverpool, Antony Fowler, just 21 years old, who's going to be making his debut in the WSB. But this guy has got great credentials, and we'll have to see how this matches up as we move up. Sean O'Grady loves the middleweights. He can tell you why.
Yeah. Oh, they got the power of the heavyweights and the speed of the lighter weights. They are the pinnacle of the boxing divisions. No, not over one. Let's see, not over 161 pounds in the amateur ranks. In the pro ranks, it's 160 pounds, and they carry that well.
It's going to be an interesting matchup from the standpoint that we've got a very tall middleweight coming in for the British team, Antony Fowler, 5'11". 5'11", so let's get the announcement and bring these fighters in from Michael Vale.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our first fighter to the ring, representing the British Lionhearts, Antony the Machine Fowler. And now let's welcome his opponent to the ring, representing your USA Knockouts, Marquis Marvelous Moore. Let's get the action started. Our next bout is in the middleweight division and is scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He's wearing the red trunks with white trim. Official weight, 160 pounds. He has an amateur record of 88 wins, just 14 losses, 27 is wins coming by way of a knockout. From Liverpool, please welcome Antony the Machine Fowler. And now let's welcome his opponent across the ring in the blue corner. He is wearing the blue trunks with white trim. Official weight, 161 and one half pounds. He has an amateur record of 75 wins, 25 losses, 20 of his wins coming by way of a knockout. From Temple Hill, Maryland, let's welcome Marquis Marvelous Moore. The referee in charge of the action, Thomas Taylor.
Thomas Taylor's your referee, one of the fine, outstanding referees we see in Southern California. He'll be in charge of the action inside the ring. Marquis Moore, I was talking about before we brought the introductions out. He's 5'7", says he prefers to fight fighters that are taller. Yeah. He doesn't see many that are shorter.
Yeah, exactly. Not in this division anyway. And he loves that. He gets low.
He's hard to hit when he's low like that. A lot of his opponents hit their top of his head or the top of his shoulders. And you got, when somebody gets low like that, or fights so low, there goes the mouthpiece. I think
mouthpiece came out.
That is Moore's mouthpiece, I believe. It was a right uppercut thrown by Fowler.
They're going to have to. The rule is that you have to find a lull in the action where you can get the mouthpiece back.
That is. I'm sorry.
You're trying to find a moment. We saw the mouthpiece out there, but Thomas Taylor's going to try to find it and wash the thing off.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I've seen them before, but they just picked up the mic mouthpiece and put it right back in. Yeah, go ahead, Jeff. Get out there. So I'm glad they washed it off. That's the right thing to do.
Marquis nice Moore is from Washington, D.C. area, 21 years old. We saw him fight 2 years ago against a fine fighter, William Williams, who's well known in the amateur ranks. Nice body shot downstairs. Now he's going to get right inside on you. He's a banger.
Got to go to the body.
He idolizes Marvin Hagler, so that'll tell you. He kind of moves like Marvin a little bit there, doesn't he?
Fights a little bit like the Marvelous One. You know, he's going downstairs to the body. The right thing to do, especially when you're facing someone taller than you, like he does all the time. Look at the shoulders on him. I talked about the shoulders on Gardein. Look at him on him. He's big, wide span. He's been doing some push-ups.
Well, you see Antony Fowler from Liverpool here. He's trying to work that reach advantage and keep that jab out there. He told us that before the fight. I got to work that jab. But as Sean always tells you, it's one thing to throw a jab, but to throw an effective jab, you got to have one to keep a guy like Marquis off of you. Marquis Moore is going to walk right through it if it's not an effective jab that you throw out there.
Of course, and look at him drag that jab. Look at him, he brings that left hand down by his waist. You know, he throws a jab, then he goes down to his waist. Fowler does. You got to bring that jab right back up, 2 points, right to your opponent, right to your head, right to your face, up to your eyebrows. Protect yourself at all times. Watch the back of your head, says the referee. Good foot feints from him, too. Fowler feigning with that front left foot. Mixing it up. This is the first round. This is the first round.
That's what you get in the WSB, 5 rounds of action. That's why people have been attracted to this series all around the world. You don't have any rounds to take off, and you have just enough rounds to determine who's going to get the scoring correct with 5 rounds. You don't have any draws.
And it is top competition. These two are facing one another. They're facing each other. Many times in the professional ranks or the amateur ranks, they don't face each other until they get built up a little bit. Look how low he gets. I like this work. Moore gets down into a ball. He rolls himself up. And then he comes out of that with punches.
Comes out like a snake.
Get in there, and, you know, get in on an angle, too. You attack at an angle. Get downstairs, go in. Get on the side and go in. Maybe the other side and go in.
Blistering first round, almost done. Looks like they just almost got in there, but you see how this is going to go. In the middleweight division.
Time.
Good action.
Very
one.
Good action.
Tough round to score.
A tough round, but you know what? It was Moore that was, it was affecting the action. He was the one moving forward. I don't know. I thought some of that in the previous fight, but even so here, continuing on, I don't think it helped in the previous fight, but maybe it'll help in this one. Moore, there is Fowler. Fowler has some good, quick, snappy punches, and when he does, watch this. In comes Moore, and a nice uppercut. Look at that, a left uppercut. That's a great weapon to use. It splits your opponent right between his elbows, and you come right up in the inside. You try to hit him right under the chin, just like that, and the mouthpiece comes flying out.
There's another that we don't want a fighter with his jaw open, because that's the way it gets broken. Sean always tells these fighters, make sure you clamp down on that mouthpiece.
Bite that mouthpiece,
because you can get a broken jaw real quick. Round number two, middleweight division. Antony Fowler is in the red trunks fighting for the British Lionhearts, and Marquis Moore in the blue trunks. He stepped inside. That's what he kind of was. That was almost an elbow punch right there. But Antony Fowler, he's got a lot of ring savvy, a champion from Liverpool. He is the National Elite Amateur British Association champion from 2 years ago. He is last year's
British World
Champion.
He's hurt.
He just nailed him right on the inside right there. Marquis is stunned.
Yeah. Down goes Moore. Breathe. Come on, breathe. You got to breathe. He stands up like that. That's a bit dangerous thing to do. That's why they take a knee when they try to get up, because you get up too fast and you wobble around.
I was just
he's hurt again. He's still hurt.
He's still hurt. He's going to go down now. Thomas Taylor's going to take a look at this one.
That's two. He is still wobbly. Take some deep breaths. You got to recoup yourself here. Marquis.
I don't know. I don't know if he can come to Taylor right here. We'll see. He's going to let it go.
He's going to stay close, though. Look, you got a minute and a half to go to the round halfway over. And
Fowler
scoring
right there. Fowler, he is a sharpshooter right now. Got a desperate Moore here right now, but Fowler is a sharpshooter. I was just telling you about all the championships he's won. Tough kid from Liverpool has put Moore down twice in this second round in the middleweight
good
division.
Uppercut.
Fowler, over the top, body shots. Fowler's got the full arsenal, folks, and he's just walking right in here in Orange County and putting on a show. He's a very tough competitor, Marquis Moore, and he has just destroyed him in the second round.
When you face one shorter than you, and when it squats down like Moore does, those uppercuts work very handily.
115, a long time left in round number two. Moore seems to be in control of his faculties at this point. Before he takes some punishment. We'll see Fowler's experience here if he's going to be patient. A hurt fighter's a dangerous fighter. Left hand there from Fowler once again.
No knockdown.
That was a slip.
Here, give me gloves.
That
give
just
gloves.
Tells me indication.
What heart? What heart? Good buys him a little time too. Sorry, Al.
That's all right. Moore is just wobbly in every aspect as well he should be at this point.
Well, he may have cleared the cobwebs too. A few seconds there may have helped him.
Blood coming from the nose and mouth of Marquis Moore in the blue trunks. Fighting for the USA knockout, but he is getting a whooping here, to say the least, in the second. Uppercut charging. Fowler has just right hand over the tail.
That's
a delayed knockout.
That's it. Wow, what a punch.
That punch.
Overhand right.
And you saw the delay on the punch. It elected, and all the circuits went loose right there. Marquis Moore went down three times in the second round. A devastating knockout. Welcome, everybody, to WSB from Antony Fowler. Here I am, and how do you do? The Great Britain champion comes to Orange County and takes care of business in a devastating style. Marquis Moore is still on the canvas. The doctor's watching him. They're going to try to get him up to the stool. Take a look at it, Sean.
What a shot, and look at this. The uppercut did a lot of damage. I think there was an overhand right in here, like right there. Now look at the legs. Look at the legs of Moore. That's how relaxed one gets when he gets knocked out. Look, his legs almost folded underneath him. It's like you get hit with something and all your muscles leave the arena and you just fall down like a Raggedy Ann doll. Very painful.
He was on shaky ground from the first knockdown for the whole time. He never fully recovered from it. And that was just a devastating combination there of a great, great fighter in Antony Fowler, who is really making his name known around the world. He's inspired his inspiration. Well, there's Marquis. We hope he's all right.
Yes,
Antony
we do.
Fowler says his inspiration is Ricky Hatton. That's somebody to look up to. Fighter in great shape, middleweight fighter. All right, let's see how this all was set up that led to the final knockout, Sean. Here's the first one. And it came rather quickly and early in the round, which has left him a long way to go. Right hand and left.
And this was right at about 1 minute, 30 seconds in the round. And look at this accuracy. Right from Fowler on the right on the chin, on the point of the nose. And down goes Marquis. He gets up from that. He goes on to be clocked again. But look how relaxed he is there. You know, his body, his muscles, everything else I'm talking about, they're cutting his gloves off now. They've got him sitting on a stool, which is the right thing to do. Don't try to stand him up. You can't stand at this point. Just sit him there on a stool, let him get some ice in the back of his neck or have a little bit of water, and, you know, try to get him to take some deep breaths. Very dangerous thing. I've seen people hurt. I've seen people hurt badly in this situation. And he's disappointed in himself, but you know what? It's boxing. You're gonna get hit. Sometimes you're gonna get clocked. I've been on that stool just the same fashion, sitting there with just disappointment on my face because I got knocked out.
All right, let's get the official announcement. We know what happened. Let's get the official announcement from our ring announcer, Michael Vail.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout ends at 2:38 of round number two. Referee Thomas Taylor stops this bout for your winner by knockout. Antony the Machine Fowler.
Very, very impressed with Antony Fowler from Liverpool. He's the two-time Great Britain champion. The last 2 years, and for him to come over here, Marquis Moore was in against a superior amateur who's just 21 years old. And of all the fighters I've seen in the last 3 years, and there's been hundreds in this series, Antony Fowler may have the stuff that dreams are made of. Let's set it up to Sean O'Grady.
All right, thank you, Alan. Wow, that was very impressive. How did you see that punch come out from your standpoint?
Well, I know I'm heavy handed with my right hand, so the coaches, Lee and Nigel, said, wait behind your jab. Short of fight, he's going to try and roll underneath me. And I knew he'd walk onto the backhand eventually. First round of box, I caught him a few times, straight down the middle. As soon as the hooks landed, that's when he went.
Did he walk right into your shot?
I can't remember, it was that fast.
Did he help you in that way?
He was coming in because he knew he was giving away height and range, so he had to close the gap. Me being naturally long arms, and I'm only a welterweight. I'm fighting at middleweight, I'm a welterweight, so I've got the speed as well. So this weight, I'm deadly at this weight, and I know I can go to this Lionhearts all the way to the top this year.
Oh, these kids, they all learn something in these matches. Tell me one thing you learned, Antony, in this fight tonight.
Just to keep me composure, when I hit the lad, don't rush in and try and finish him off, because he did catch me with a few little swings, but for a solid chin, he never hit me. But if he'd have been a bit of a bigger puncher, he could have hit me. So like Lee said, he's a top coach. Junior Ayrton, don't step on him. Just keep the pressure on, nice and composed, and the shot will come again, because he was getting desperate the longer it went on. And the more he tried to swing, the more vulnerable he was.
Some nice uppercuts from you tonight. Why is that? Is it because he was bending over and squatting down?
I'm not really known for uppercuts. I'm normally a long-range fighter, but with him rolling underneath, I had to adapt, and the uppercuts came, and you see what happened.
Wow, what an exciting fighter. Thank you so much. How about that Orange County? Eric Fowler. Hey, I'm told that last knockout might be the Rip-It shot of the night. The Rip-It energy drink shot of the night. Antony Fowler, maybe a Rip-It drink.
That's fine by me.
There you go. Alan Fowler. How about that, Alan?
Okay.
Eric Fowler.
Antony.
Antony Fowler. Hey, some Fowler. There's a lot of Fowlers tonight. Antony Fowler did a terrific job, and this is a name you're going to hear a lot more in the future. I like it.
USA, it's a great country, and I'm proud to be here.
Great.
Thank you.
How about that, Orange County? Alan?
Yeah, quite charming group to come over here with the British team, and this young man, in my humble opinion, has some special stuff. We'll see how he goes along in this series this year. He could be in the middleweight division for the championship when that's decided next May.